Hello, my name is Jones Muna. Today, we're looking at vesico-vaginal fistula. An opening from the bladder to the vagina, either from error during operation or from ulceration, as may occur in carcinoma of the cervix. F. Weller 2002. Causes of vesico-vaginal fistula. Vesico-vaginal fistula is common in women who do not attend antenatal care. Cephalic presentation with prolonged labor due to cephalopelvic disproportion. This is due to constant pressure. There is devitalization of tissue of the base or neck of the bladder, which leads to ischemia, necrosis and excoriation of the tissue, and sloughing, leaving a hole between vagina and bladder. Cause. 1. Mechanical trauma from difficult instrument deliveries can also cause a fistula. The forceps used during forceps delivery may traumatize the tissue and cause the fistula. 2. Pelvic surgery, hysterectomy or vagina reconstruction procedures and repair of the bladder. During this procedures the bladder may be injured and a fistula is caused. 3. Malignancy, that is cancer of the cervix or bladder. Cancer of the cervix causes fistula because of abnormal multiplication of cells that weakens the tissue integrity and a fistula is caused. 4. Radiation therapy following treatment of cancer of the cervix with radiotherapy. Radiation rays destroys even normal cells. 5. Paraplegic patients with catheters in situ for long time, which is balloon. The balloon will be pressing on the bladder tissue and causes inflammation and a fistula may occur. Predisposing factors. 1. Poor nutrition, especially in debilitating conditions like anemia. 2. Neglected, prolonged and/or obstructed. 3. Inadequate or unavailable transport, thereby delaying arrival from a hospital. Lack of skilled attendance, failure of woman to come to a hospital, or refusal of permission for hospital treatment from husband. Signs and symptoms. 1. Urine incontinence. 2. Continuous trickling of urine into vagina. 3. Stress incontinence depending on the size of the fistula. 4. Soreness around vulva and the vagina, excoriation of skin due to ammonia in urine. 5. An abnormal limping gait. Management of vesico-vaginal fistula. Investigation. Urine for culture and sensitivity to rule out any infection. Colposcopy, direct visual examination of the viscera through an endoscope. Colposcopy, direct visual examination of the viscera through an endoscope. Cystoscopy. Performed to determine number and location of fistulas. Fistulogram. Injection of a dye into the vagina, which can help to assess the location and extent of the fistula. Urinalysis to rule out any abnormalities. Full blood count may show raised leukocytes if there is any urinary tract infection. Management. An indwelling catheter for 2 to 3 weeks to encourage the fistula to close spontaneously. Give fluids up to 3 liters daily to flush out the bladder. Antibiotics may be given to treat the urinary tract infection. Give drug to treat anemia. Surgical repair is undertaken if no spontaneous healing occurs in 8 to 10 weeks. This to allow complete resolution of inflammation and infection. The repair is performed using a support graft and vaginal wall is closed. An indwelling catheter is inserted for 14 days. Preoperative care. The patient is admitted in the ward and put on complete bed rest to ensure healing with free air circulation. Psychological care. Let patient be admitted in the general ward to allow her socialize with other patients to avoid depression. Explain the condition using diagrams, if possible, and what is going to be done on her to allay anxiety. Explain all investigations and treatment given to gain patient's cooperation. Encourage visitors to prevent patient isolation that can lead to depression. Recognize value of meeting psychosocial needs such as feminine morale boosters like attractive hairdo, nail polish, perfume. Provide recreation activities to provide diversional therapy and prevent depression. Observations. Vital signs of temperature, pulse, respiration and blood pressure should be done 4 hourly to detect any deviation from normal. Incontinent is observed for smell, color and amount. Observe for signs of depression like isolation, mood swings and loss of appetite. Observe for signs of anemia like pallor, which is a predisposing factor to fistulas. Hygiene. 6-hourly vulva toilet to prevent a odor and maintain comfort of the patient. Encourage frequent pad changing to avoid the smell. Change the linen frequently for the comfort of the patient. Sitz baths are encouraged at least twice a day to prevent skin excoriation. Use the deodorants to prevent smell. Provide optimum skin care to prevent excoriation. Use bland cream or light dusting of cornstarch may be soothing. Nutrition. Maintain adequate nutrition, increased intake of vitamins and proteins of meals to repair the worn out tissue and boosting the immunity. Give copious fluids to flush out the catheter and increase diuresis. Give iron foods like spinach to improve the hemoglobin levels. Iron supplements. Elimination. Catheterization will be done as long the patient is in the ward for the comfort of the patient and prevent soiling of the bed. Monitor intake and output by use of the fluid balance chart. Immediate post-operative care. Ensure catheter is in situ for easier drainage. If patient has a lot of pubic hair, trim, because surgery may be done abdominally. An intravenous fluid is put in place. Patient should starve at least 4 to 6 hours before surgery to prevent aspiration. A bath is given before surgery. Consent is signed to allow procedure. Observations of temperature, pulse, respiration and blood pressure to act as baseline data preoperatively. Post-operative care. Post-operative care of any patient undergoing anesthesia applies to the patient after repair of the fistula. Observations. The blood pressure, pulse rate and respiratory rate are done 1/4, 1/2 and graduate to normal recording as the patient becomes stable. The body temperature is recorded every 4 hours. Observe the catheter for proper drainage. Observe for any leakage of urine from the vagina. Observe for any bleeding on the suture line. Nutrition fluid therapy. Patient is maintained on intravenous fluids until she gains consciousness from anesthesia. Intravenous fluids will be given at least 4 to 6 liters in 24 hours to allow proper drainage of the bladder. Graduate patients diet from liquid to semi-solid foods till she is able to tolerate solids. The food should contain carbohydrates for energy, proteins for worn-out tissues and vitamins to boost the immunity. Encourage patient to take plenty of fluids to flush out the bladder. Elimination. Maintain proper drainage from indwelling catheter, otherwise, pressure may build up and be exerted against newly sutured tissue. Ensure the catheter is draining well. Monitor urine output by use of the fluid balance chart. Observe the urine for any blood stains that may indicate injury to the bladder. Family planning. Discuss with the patient the method you have of family planning and let her choose the best option. Tell her the importance of preventing pregnancy for 2 years or more to avoid reoccurrence of the fistula. Discuss with her the importance of complete healing before pregnancy to avoid stretching of the tissues. Discuss the side effects of the family planning she has chosen. Involve the husband in the family planning choice, if married, for easier compliance. Patient teaching. Teach patient on the importance of early antenatal booking in subsequent pregnancy to ensure proper monitoring. Teach patient on the importance of hospital or facility delivery to prevent reoccurrence of the fistula. Tell patient that in subsequent pregnancy cesarean section may be indicated to avoid fistula reoccurrence. Teach patient to observe any urine leakage and report to the medical personnel immediately. Tell patient to seek medical attention whenever unwell.